advantage de ser con un proposal ya propagar center and wala masyado magdidebate pero kung teaching kids how to read and mga political issues syempre everyone has something to say pero no one would dare debate with Secretary Boy on issues that he would bring up full support agad pati mga budgetary na wala nang bawas agad somebody would immediately say both I therefore propose that we approve tapos kaagad pabilisan kaya and we have always supported each other. I think it's a wonderful partnership. Our days go back to the presidency of President Emil Cordier has always supported advancement of science and technology. He was our only gentleman vice president, lahat mga babae. And interestingly, including President Javier, as Boy mentioned, kami mga dragon. Ako, I was a metal dragon, pangalan ni President Javier. Ang pinakakul sa atin, water dragon siya. So Boy, who is an ox, did a lot of work. Kasi kung ano-ano ang mga naiisip ng mga female dragons. And we had a very wonderful, challenging partnership in the University of the Philippines. Chair of the Benito Siya Foundation, our supporters. I'm very happy to see that our teachers and our students are here. This is a great opportunity to be aware and to catch up on all of the developments, all the new things that are happening in education. And very timely yung choice ng theme is on innovations in basic Philippine education. While all of us agree that civilization can only move forward with innovation. Dapat we should start hindi yung sa university level or graduate level or postgraduate level. We have to start with basic education, the notion of innovation, of creating something new, of making sense of what is going on around us. I will do away with the definition of innovation. I mentioned it kanina. And also the reflections of various experts on the fourth industrial revolution or the Fire E. Kasi alam naman natin, I'm talking to converts, so hindi na kailangan mag-preach pa ako niyan about industry 4.0. Alam na ninyo yan. And lalo na those who are in engineering and in technology. Gusto kong mag-focus this morning on challenges to think in education in terms of innovation. There's so much data. Nung unang panahon, children were taught data, they were taught history, when was Magellan discovered, and so on and so forth, si Galileo Galilei, etc. And dami-dami, but these are all available in one click. Computers, even sa cell phone natin. Everyone has a cell phone. You have heard the story of the child in another country who thought that she would commit suicide kung mawala yung kanyang cell phone because everything, kung buhay niya, doon niya sa provided for by the cell phone. So these are all accessible. So we are moving forward. And karamihan natin sa kadami ng data, sa kadami ng information, hirap tayo na pagturo ng ating mga bata kung anong gawin itong kadami-daming data. Ang dali-dali namang mapuha na nakakalito. And then you also have artificial intelligence. Mayroong movies sa Netflix and so on. And artificial intelligence has changed the way people learn. in our conferences, the mga ministers of education, particularly in Southeast Asia and in Asia, I mean, we discuss very, very seriously the implications of increasing dependence on artificial intelligence and how we can utilize this to further prepare our learners for the world outside. But at the same time, we ask ourselves, is that what we really want? Is this what we really want? And even the minister of Singapore said that, number one, kasi ang Singapore ngayon, in terms of the PISA results, in terms of advancements in teaching, sabi nga niya, I do not want my grandchildren to be taught by a robot. See, in one country, in Asia, for example, they're already developing robot teachers, robot teaching assistants. Kasi at least ang robot, sisira-sira na o lumaluma na, papalitan lang, no? Hindi naman maglarali, hindi naman maglarali, kailangan bigyan ng uniform, at saka constantly improving ang robot. And the robot monitors the children very easily through algorithms. Alam nila kung sinong mga inaantok, sinong hindi nangikinig. Konektado sila at each other. And hindi na masisira yung balamoda ng teacher kasi they use smart platforms. I have seen some of these modern classrooms which they OST developed for our senior high schools within operation of local governments. So, and they developed itong mga personalized study programs. Only yesterday, one of our leading donor countries made a presentation, a huge country connecting all schools in terms not only of information and data about students, but when it comes to speaking lectures and so on. And sabi nila na in one country which is now grappling with NCOV, classes continue through IDC. Because children, they don't have to leave their homes. So, when you say suspended their classes, in some schools are able to carry on their classes, etc., through communications. And we have to develop that capacity because we are regularly undergoing all sorts of natural as well as political challenges. So, kasi yung iba, ang thinking nila, makaka-help ito. Not literally teacher shortage, but shortage of good teachers. You can have hundreds of thousands of teachers, but you cannot have very many, many countries don't have very many good teachers. So kailangan i-replicate sila yung mga pinakamagagaling na teachers, yung lectures nila, they can talk to any school or to any institution or to any official in the entire organization through technology.